Well, let's talk to Tomi Lahren. She's out on the left coast. She joins us right now. Of course, she's one of the hosts from the upcoming Fox Nation. Tomi, what is former Speaker Pelosi talking about with the It's a Manhood issue?
Well, first of all, I'll remind you that Speaker Pelosi is also the same woman that told us that sometimes mowing the grass near the border is a more effective option than a border wall. So let's start there. But furthermore, a border wall is not a manhood issue. It's an immigration issue. It's a border enforcement issue, and it's an American issue. And I would also remind her that there are millions of American women who voted for Donald Trump to build that wall, and we certainly don't have a manhood issue.
What do you make of this caravan coming toward the United States? I think it's currently in Honduras, and the president yesterday said, hey, Honduras, Guatemala, El Salvador, if you don't stop your people from coming here, we're going to cut off the cash.
Well, he's exactly right, and that's exactly what our president needs to do to secure our border. If other countries aren't going to cooperate, they're not going to help us secure our border, they're not going to secure their own, then we're going to have to resort to that. But I tweeted this yesterday. Wouldn't it be nice if we had a big, fat border wall there so when this caravan came to our border, we wouldn't have to worry about this issue? Boy, I can't wait for that to happen.
Right. Hey, Tomi, there was a headline in BuzzFeed, and this is what it reads. It says, suburban women are fed up with the Republican Party and could drive a blue wave. Are they underestimating the power of women like you, the Republican base?
Well, they also told us that Hillary had a 93% chance of winning, and I remind them that Hillary is not my president and she's not their president either. But look, they underestimate the whisper voter. They underestimate the voters who don't go out in the street and march with pink hats and vulgar signs, but we do march into the voting booth. So, like they thought in November of 2016, where they were going to have this surge of women voting for Hillary, voting for Democrats, that's not going to happen. Once again, we are going to vote with our pocketbook. We're going to vote for national security, border security, and we're going to vote for our Republican candidates. They're going to secure that.
So Hillary got the female vote, but President Trump got 53% of the white female vote. The midterm elections will be another chance for both genders to weigh in, hypothetically. We assume they will. Here's what the president said about it.
I had worse poll numbers when I went into the last election. And you saw how well I did with women. I mean, if you looked at my poll numbers going into 2016, you would have said, there's not a woman in the country that's going to vote for me. And I did phenomenal with women. They want security, and they want financial security, too.
So, Tomi, he feels optimistic that the polls are just wrong.
I don't believe in polls since the last election either, because again, a lot of the things that women or men for that matter say to pollsters, that they say when they're taking any type of a survey, is not what they're actually going to do in their vote, because in this country, Trump supporters and conservative Republican supporters have been shamed into not saying who they actually support. So again, when they go into that voting booth by themselves, they're going to vote their conscience, they're going to vote for America first, and they're going to vote for Republican candidates that are going to make sure that happens.
Do you think it's problematic for more than just Stormy Daniels when the president tweets out horse face?
Well, again, you might not like the president's style, but if he's effective economically and he's going to build that border wall, I could really care less what he says about Stormy Daniels.
All right. Tomi Lahren joining us from Los Angeles, one of the hosts of the upcoming Fox Nation. If you'd like more information and brand new streaming service, go to foxnation.com.
Thank you, Tomi.